Hey everyone, this is SpyFan101. I'm here today to talk about the newest episode of Charmed. Now, the ending revelation in this episode is really messing with my head right now, but I'll get to it. First of all, let me talk about the great things about this episode. One, the fact that Rogelio from Jane the Virgin is in this episode, but as a different character, not actually as Rogelio. And Gina Rodriguez herself directed this episode. That's crazy, man. Congratulations to her, man. She got this movie, Miss Bala, coming out, and she's directing this, and I don't know when Jane the Virgin Season 5 is coming out, but we got that coming. Man, just huge props to Jane. I was about to say Jane. Huge props to Gina, man. But yeah, that's one great thing. Also, I love how this episode was paced. Like, from how it was advertised, I was like, yeah, this is gonna be filler. But no, like, it actually had, there was actually tension to it. Like, for example, when Rogelio was possessed by, you know, the magical demon that controls music and all this and wants to be, like, the main thing and wants the credit for all the music being played. And, you know, I tell you what, his acting was so good in this episode. Because, you know, he was being serious. And usually, like, in Jane the Virgin, he plays, like, the comedy relief dad. Like, he's the funny dad. Let's laugh at him. But no. Like, he was actually, like, stern and serious in this version. I mean, he had his funny moments, but, you know, for the most part, he was serious. And, you know, that's some great acting right there. And in terms of the sisters, we have my girl Macy telling Mel and Maggie that, you know, basically, you know, you and Mel are like half sisters, and, you know, you and me, Maggie, we're like full sisters. And so, because in the last episode we found out that, you know, Michael Macy's father is also Maggie's father. And so that would explain a lot of things. And it turns out that, you know, at one point in the episode, my girl Macy mentions the fact that, you know, her father is dead. And so that's why, you know, he's not there. So, you know, it seems like, you know, their mother has been keeping so many secrets from them. Man, those are some secretive parents right there. You could almost say that they were a part of S.H.I.E.L.D. They're keeping so many secrets. But anyway, we also get a return of some other characters as well. We have the leader, we have the former leader of the Campa Troopers as one of the main a cappella artists in this episode. And, you know, what really surprised me is that their relationship, Maggie and Leader's relationship, was actually, you know, quite tame in this episode. And, you know, I liked it. I really did like it. But, you know, it was kind of weird because, you know, they left off on, like, a really bad foot last time. In terms of the whole situation with, you know, how am I forgetting his name? Anyway, you had that situation. And then you had all the other things going on with that cheerleader that was dead, that was, you know, taking control of her and everything. It was like a whole thing. But no, their relationship was quite tame in this episode, and that was pretty good. What else? Mel and what's going on with Jada. And Migo is actually crazy because now Migo is a private investigator. And, you know, she's investigating Jada because her family is looking for her. They think she joined a cult, which I don't know if the Sarkata really count as a cult, but, you know. Anyway, so, you know, she's being followed, and then there's, of course, the tension between Miko and Mel, because, you know, the last time we saw Miko, besides the times in the previous episode where she was eavesdropping, taking pictures of Jada and Mel kissing, you know, it was when Mel had to erase her memory so that the shapeshifter, you know, would stop going after her. And so, yeah, that was really interesting as well. But the ending of this episode was crazy. So we see that my girl Macy and Maggie are, you know, upstairs reading these letters from from my girl Macy's father. And, you know, Maggie seems really distressed when she's reading one of them. And then my girl Macy grabs it from her, starts reading it. And then we realize my girl Macy was resurrected from the dead. It was so intense, my camera dropped. What? My girl Macy was dead? Oh my god. This is crazy. How is this gonna shape up? I don't know how this is gonna end. I seriously don't know how this is gonna end. That was crazy. That threw me for a loop. My girl Macy has been dead. Anyway, this episode was just great. I love the relationship between my girl Macy and Galvin in this episode. I love the relationship between Mel and Jada in this episode. I just love all the relationships. They're great. The writing was good. The directing was good. Once again, great job, Gina Rodriguez. And everything was absolutely beautiful about this episode. So without a doubt, I'm going to give this a 10 out of 10. This episode was way better than I thought it was going to be. And, you know, this is going to be a little bit shorter because, you know, my camera's running out. My memory card's running out of space right now. It's giving me a timer right here. So, yeah. Overall, I'm going to give it a 10 out of 10. This episode was just fantastic. So, yeah. I'm SpideyFan101 saying peace.